The video shows you how to install SharePoint 2013 on Windows Server 2012. But before we can go on, we need to make sure we are logged on using the SharePoint Setup Administrator. And second, that this account is a member of the local administrators group on the server. The video is part of a series of 6 videos showing you the installation of SharePoint 2013. I'm going to install SharePoint on 2 different virtual machines, where the left one is used to run Active Directory and the right one is used to run SQL Server and SharePoint. As I said earlier, we need to manually assign permission to the SharePoint Setup Administrator. And this account needs to be in the administrators group of each server where SharePoint should be installed. Open Server Manager and click Tools and Computer Management to check if the SharePoint Setup Administrator has been added to the local administrators group. Open Local Users and Groups. Check groups and double click administrators. And here you can see the SharePoint Setup Administrator has been added to the local administrators group. So this server is okay in order to install SharePoint 2013. First of all, we have to install required roles and features as well as software, so we are going to run the prerequisites installer. And here you need to carefully read the results, since you may have to restart your server. Here you can see that a restart is pending and that the installation of a feature has been skipped, so we need to restart the server here. Please note, after you have logged on again, you don't need to start the installer since it automatically continues where it has stopped before. After all prerequisites have been installed, you can run setup. And after accepting the license agreement and using your product key, you can select a complete installation type. After the installation has finished, you need to run the product's configuration wizard. And here you need to create a new server farm. On the next screen, you need to specify the database server and at the bottom, you need to specify the SharePoint farm account, which is used for configuration and management of the SharePoint farm. If you have finished the installation, click Finish and Central Administration will open. As you know, I offer professional SharePoint training in addition to my free training. The SharePoint installation training material contains a PDF guide, and you can use this guide either to manually create a SharePoint form or to automatically create a SharePoint form. And it doesn't matter which form. You can create a 3-tier form, 2-tier, 4-tier, or a development environment. And as I said, you can do it all automatically using up to 46 PowerShell scripts. And if you're stuck in the middle of the installation and have problems, you can use the troubleshooting tips. And of course, there is bonus material included.